sometimes the complicated design is done by the repetition of the form. We're going to use this flower pendant to discuss this simple technique. Let's get started. We are going to go to the front view and draw a petal there. Let's go ahead to design this outline. I'm going to draw something more like a leaf looking things, have that curve to mirror to the other side. Now, once I've done it, I would like to run off the tip by going to the curve. You have fit a curve, and let's go ahead to fit it that one and also fit it this one. And let's go ahead to join all of them. Now let's go to the top view and we want to draw a sphere snapping to the zero. I want to be something like roughly about this big. Alright, now we want to go to the front view and take a look on where you want this location is for the petal, and then we can kind of line up them in the center and use this petal to trim the rest of the form. If you look at the perspective view, you're going to see two forms over there, right? We only need one of them. Alright, so now we have the curve now turning to the surface. How can we get this surface into the solid? By using the command, it's called offset surface. Make sure that solid equal no, because we just need another piece over there. And you can decide the thickness for whatever is suitable for you. Then we are going to use the blend tool, and we're going to blend from this edges to that edges. Again, you can adjust the blend if it is too pointed or too rounded, or if you like that, just click OK. Now I want to join all of them. Double check on my property over here. Make sure it's closed polished surface. This is will be the basic of our flower. Now I'm looking at my right view and I want to tilt this flower a little bit and move it to the center a little bit. So this will be my first layer. I'm planning to have four layers over there. I'm going to make a copy and paste. And with that one, gonna use the rotate tool to rotate and make it a little bit lower. So my flower won't look really stiff. So I do have a two different layer. The one that I lower a little bit, I'm going to rotate it 60 degrees from the center. So then we have two petals there, one is up, one is down, but they're still connected for casting purpose. Then let's array them into a circle. We're gonna use polar array, hit zero for our center, and we want three of them. So that's how we get this shape over here. Let's go ahead to group it and bringing up with the gumbo, use the hit the Alt key to make a copy. Now we have two set of them. But this time, we need to make it slightly smaller so we get this shape over here. I'm going to change those into the red color so you can see much better. Alright, so the form is like overlapping too much and it's way too symmetrical. So for the red one, I'm going to use the rotate tool that's snapping into the center, and let's rotate 30 degrees here. So now it is more variety. You can move it up a little bit if that worked for you, or you can kind of 1D scale on the other one. Let's do something like this. So that way we'll give you more variety over there. And you can also hold on both of them to make them a little bit lower. So that will be our flower. All you need to do next is put a prong set in the middle, or you can have a bezel set. If you'd like to know how to do the prong set, you can click the video right here on the right top. It will take you to the video that I have done before. And finally, let's add the bell. Let's take a look on the render view. This will be the flower design for today's tutorial. If you are the first time here, I would like to invite you to subscribe my channel. There will be more Rhino for jewelry design coming up every week. Thank you for watching. I'll see you next.